Alrighty guys, what's going on? Linky here, and in today's video, we're doing a little bit of a follow-up to my Pal Park video that I did with Chrome and Eyes last week, in that we've gotten the features confirmed for the Pal Park. It is no longer the Pal Park in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. It is the Romanus Park, the Romanus Park. I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but in today's video, we are going to be delving into some of the features they revealed earlier this week for the Romanus Park. We're going to talk about why it's a really exciting piece to the entire Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl puzzle. I did a big discussion with my friend Ryan, aka Chrome and Eyes, last week about what the Pal Park would become in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. We speculated in that video, in jest a little bit, that this video could be defunct in a couple days because they could reveal what the use of the Pal Park is very quickly, and that is exactly what happened. Now, of course, it did get leaked beforehand with the data mine that has now been done of Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. We had a good look at what was going to be in this part of the game. We didn't have it fully confirmed because some features were actually locked out of this data mine, as they're only coming in a patch that was just added to the games that you'll be able to download when the game comes out. It was added on the 11th, even though the games come out on the 19th, but that's a discussion for another day about the launch of these games. But the Romanus Park is replacing the Pal Park, and it is essentially a hub for legendary Pokemon. You are going to be able to find a bunch of different stones, statues that look very similar to the old GBA and GB cartridges that your Pokemon originally came in their original games. And you're going to be able to enter these special dens for each of these legendary Pokemon, and then you're going to be able to catch them. We saw everyone. We saw Rayquaza. We saw Ho-Oh. We saw Lugia. You're also going to be able to get special event Pokemon in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl if you have save data from Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee or Sword and Shield. If you go to Floromatown, you're going to be able to get Jirachi and Mew, and you are going to be able to have them on your team. You can use them if you want in your playthrough, or you can just box them like I tend to do with legendaries or mythicals. But there's suddenly a ton of catching of Pokemon that we're going to be able to do in this game that we weren't able to do before. If you guys played Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, then you would know that there were a bunch of legendaries made available. You could get the roaming birds, Moltres, Zapdos, and Articuno in the post game, and you could also go after some Pokemon like Cresselia, which also roamed. But that was really it to the extent of old Pokemon that you could catch in those games. Now, they did supplement this when Heart Gold and Soul Silver came out. In those games, you could catch a bunch of different legendaries, including Groudon, Kyogre, and Rayquaza. In Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, you're going to be able to do the same. As you can see by the thumbnail, you can get Rayquaza, my favorite legendary, in this game. It's wonderful. And to top it all off, there are going to be some version exclusive legendaries. So Ho-Oh and Lugia, for example, are going to be version exclusive. You can get Ho-Oh in Brilliant Diamond. You can get Lugia in Shining Pearl. So depending on which version of the game you get, you're going to have different Pokemon available to you in the park. So of course, that facilitates trading. That facilitates you going to your friends and saying, which one do you have? Do you want this one instead? Go on to the GTS and trade it once Pokemon Home compatibility comes out, or you're going to be able to do various other things. You could buy both games, you know. You could drop $120 to get all these legendaries that you've no doubt had multiple times now at this point throughout all the generations. Now, before we go any further, I just wanted to mention that the vast majority of you guys who are watching this video and hopefully enjoying aren't subscribed to the channel. Now, of course, subscribing is free. You can unsubscribe at any time. You can subscribe on two channels if you want, even though I wouldn't recommend that because that might not be looked upon very well, but you could. Needless to say, be sure to subscribe so you never miss another Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl video. You won't miss my BDSP live stream next week, and you won't miss any Legends Arceus videos when we're coming up to that release in January. So be sure to subscribe. There was also some talk about the park being not just a hub for legendary Pokemon, but also a hub for other trainers of other regions. And from what I'm seeing, we haven't exactly seen this yet. And maybe this is just bad wording on the part of the game itself. Maybe. You're going to have a bunch of other trainers and different characters from across the Pokemon world that you're going to be able to battle in the Romanus Park. But that's not confirmed yet. Right now, it's just a hub to get your legendaries. It's similar to the Ultra Wormholes in Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, or the Hoopa dimensions that Hoopa would bring about in Oras. It's pretty much the same thing, but it's in a nice, fun, pleasant nature preserve environment. Now, of course, this also removes a bunch of our other theories that we talked about in the previous video. It's not going to be a Pokemon home park. It's not going to be a Pokemon Go park, which I saw a lot of you guys mention in the comment section of my Pokemon Pal Park video. It's not going to be that. It's not going to be a rebranded Pal Park or some kind of new safari zone. It's not going to be a new shiny hunting method, which dispels that 4chan leak. It's not going to be a new trophy garden, which we already have in the game. It's not going to be a type garden where you can catch different types of Pokemon depending on how many friends you have in your friends list. That was something that existed in Pokemon X and Y. This is a wholly new feature. Now, of course, it's fixing a problem that we don't necessarily have. So it's an interesting dichotomy here. Generally, when Pokemon has a new generation, they like to make almost every single Pokemon in the National Dex available through all of the games. We can look at Generation 6 as a good example of this. In Pokemon X and Y, and then in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, you could get incredibly close to completing the National Dex just using those four games. In Pokemon Sun and Moon and Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, they had a ton of different Pokemon that you could catch and bring onto your team. And when they added the legendaries and the mythicals, you got very close to a National Dex. Pokemon likes to do this. What's interesting in this example is that we could already get almost all of these legendaries and all of these mythicals that you're going to be able to get in BDSP in Sword and Shield. If you had the DLC, you could access the Crown Tundra and you could adventure through the legendary raids and get all of these Pokemon. You could get the Sinnoh legendaries in the Crown Tundra. You could get the Swords of Justice and Keldeo in the wild. You could get the Regis and new Regis as well. It's interesting to me that multiple times in the same generation, because yes, Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl and eventually Legends Arceus are part of the Sword and Shield generation, you're able to get the legendaries multiple times over. It's really fascinating to me. And it makes me wonder about the development of Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Was it always the plan to have the Pal Park eventually be a legendary park? Were there other ideas thrown around? And more importantly, what does this say to us about the rest of the postgame in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl? We saw from an announcement that the Pokemon Company put out, they're going to be doing a patch for the games that comes out even before the release. And in this patch, they explain that one of the things that's going to be coming to the game is the postgame. That's all they said. They were not any more specific than that. What are they going to be adding? Now, the Romanus Park is postgame. It's something you can only access, I believe, once you complete the Pokedex. At least that's the way the Pal Park was in the originals. Who knows how it's going to function now? What other postgame content are they going to add? Are there other story bits and pieces that we have not gotten to explore yet? Are there other things that they haven't told us about? Are there things happening in the battle area and where the battle frontier was maybe that weren't in the original copies that they're now going to push with this update? There's a lot of interesting things to talk about here, and it really speaks to the fact that, listen, for as much as this is a faithful remake of Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, they are adding a bunch of things that are really fun features for players. Whether it's the Grand Underground or the Romanus Park, there's a bunch of things that you're going to be able to do that you couldn't already do in this generation. And for that, I think that it's worth it to play. Having Generation 4 on the Switch is worth it, in my opinion, on its own. As someone who loves the story of Pokemon games and going through the motions, having this game on the Switch, this region on the Switch, is fabulous. And getting these extra features to acquire legendary Pokemon is also really cool. I'm a big fan of it all the way. Now, of course, I would love to know what you guys think. Are you a fan of the Romanus Park? Am I pronouncing it correctly? Does it have a connection to Generation 8 in Pokemon Sword and Shield? Romanus is a type of rose, after all, when you translate it. It is really interesting stuff, and especially since the Crown Tundra is legendary, so there's a legendary connection with all this. I would love to know what you guys think. Be sure to leave a like on the video if you enjoyed and you want to see more Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl videos in the future. I've been LLP, and we'll see you all next week in the next video. Peace out.